الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. On behalf of the executive board of Sheikhul Ibn Taymiyyah and King Fahd Mosque, we wish you all a very happy Eid Mubarak, Eidul Adha Mubarak to all of you from myself and also the council, Brother Nuri, Brother Riyaz, Sister Salina, Brother Abdullah, Brother Muhammad, Security, Brother Hamid, also Javed, Brother Zach, Brother Farhan, Sister Halima, and Sister Najat. And we wish you all a blessed Eid al-Adha Mubarak and to you and your families. May Allah give you the barakah and the blessings of this day. You know, Jazakumullah khairan for allowing us to serve you, inshallah, in the best way possible. One request I'd like to make as more people are coming in. So if you can all stand up and form a little bit of rows and then, you know, come forward as much as you can. And then please sit down so that we have more room. Jazakumullah khair. Inshallah, we'll start in a few minutes. Okay, so we can all sit down. Alhamdulillah.
Assalamu alaikum, rahmatullah barakatuh, brothers. Can you all sit down at the back, please? Please have a seat. We should start in the next few minutes, brothers. We have a lot of brothers coming at the back. Just a humble request to all of you, those who will be donating the udhiya meat over here in the masjid, please make sure that it's in small pieces because we will not be able to accommodate the large pieces. You know, we have to make sure we have enough space, so make sure you make small pieces, a bag of 3 to 4 pounds, so that is easy for our people to distribute it to the needy. So do not bring large pieces, it will be a problem to distribute. Inshallah, we'll start in a few minutes, inshallah, and just bear with us and we can start the takbir. Assalamu alaikum.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah. Allah. ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد،
الله أكبر كبيرا، والحمد لله كثيرا، وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا، لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده، ونصر عبده، وعز جنده، وحزم الأحزاب وحده، لا إله إلا الله، ولا نعبد إلا إياه، مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد،
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد، الله أكبر كبيرا، والحمد لله كثيرا، وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا، لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده، ونصر عبده، وأعز جنده، وهزم الأحزاب وحده، لا إله إلا الله، ولا نعبد إلا إياه، مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر،
الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر، الله أكبر،
ولله الحمد،
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد، الله أكبر كبيرا، والحمد لله كثيرا، وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا، لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده،
ونصر عبده وحزم الجند
وهزم الأحزاب وحده.
لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا.
أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا. لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده. لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد.
استووا اعتدلوا سدوا الخلل. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين وإذ بوأنا لإبراهيم مكان البيت ألا تشرك بي شيئا وطهر بيتي للطائفين والقائمين والركع السجود وأذن في الناس بالحج يأتوك رجالا وعلى كل ضامر يأتين من كل فج عميق ليشهدوا منافع لهم ويذكروا اسم الله في أيام معلومات على ما رزقهم من بهيمة الأنعام فكلوا منها وأطعموا البائس الفقير ثم ليقضوا تفثهم وليوفوا نذورهم وليطوفوا بالبيت العتيق ذلك ومن يعظم حرمات الله فهو خير له عند ربه وأحلت لكم الأنعام إلا ما يتلى عليكم فاجتنبوا الرجس من الأوثان واجتنبوا قول الزور الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر 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 الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين وإن من شيعته لإبراهيم إذ جاء ربه بقلب سليم إذ قال لأبيه وقومه ماذا تعبدون أئفكا آلهة دون الله تريدون فما ظنكم برب العالمين فنظر نظرة في النجوم فقال إني سقيم فتولوا عنه مدبرين فراغ إلى آلهتهم فقال ألا تأكلون ما لكم لا تنطقون فراغ عليهم ضربا باليمين فأقبلوا إليه يزفون قال أتعبدون ما تنحتون والله خلقكم وما تعملون قالوا ابنوا له بنيانا فألقوه في الجحيم فأرادوا به كيدا فجعلناهم الأسفلين وقال إني ذاهب إلى ربي سيهدين رب هب لي من الصالحين فبشرناه بغلام حليم فلما بلغ معه السعي قال يا بني إني أرى في المنام أني أذبحك فانظر ماذا ترى قال يا أبت افعل ما تؤمر ستجدني إن شاء الله من الصابرين فلما أسلما وتله للجبين وناديناه أن يا إبراهيم قد صدقت الرؤيا إنا كذلك نجزي المحسنين إن هذا لهو البلاء المبين وفديناه بذبح عظيم وتركنا عليه في الآخرين سلام على إبراهيم كذلك نجزي المحسنين إنه من عبادنا المؤمنين الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله إن الحمد لله تفرد بالربوبية وأبان للإنسانية دلائل الألوهية، أحمده تعالى وأشكره على ما أسدى من منة وعطية ودفع من نقمة وبلية، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له أنقذنا بالبعثة المحمدية من براثن الإشراك والوثنية، وأعزنا بالتوحيد وأبطل مسالك الجاهلية. وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله خير البرية وسيد البشرية، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه الذين أشادوا صروح الحنيفية وأعلوا منار الملة المصطفوية، والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا، وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا، وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. My dear brothers and sisters, it is my honor to congratulate you today on the auspicious occasion of Eid al-Adha. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this a day of blessing, a day of happiness, and a day of prosperity for us and for Muslims around the world. This day, the 10th of Dhul Hijjah, it is a culmination of the greatest days of the year. The first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, about which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَا مِنْ أَيَّامٍ الْعَمَلُ الصَّالِحُ فِيهِنَّ أَحَبُّ إِلَى اللَّهِ مِنْ هَذِهِ الْأَيَّامِ. That there are no days where good deeds are more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than these 10 days, the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. And the culmination of those days and the final one of those days is today, the 10th of Dhul Hijjah, which is, according to many opinions, the greatest day of the year, based upon the hadith where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَعْظَمُ الْأَيَّامِ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ يَوْمُ النَّحْرِ. The greatest of days with Allah is the day of the sacrifice, and that is the day of Eid al-Adha, the 10th of Dhul Hijjah. So we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for allowing us to reach this day. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for acceptance, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us many more opportunities like this in the future. The 10th of Dhul Hijjah, the day of Eid, is a day where there are so many different forms of ibadah that are combined, that come together, unlike other days of the year. For those who have been invited by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to visit His house for Al-Hajj, the day of the 10th of Dhul Hijjah is Yawmul Hajj Al-Akbar. It is the greatest day of Hajj. It is the day where the Hujjaj stone Jamratul Aqaba. It is the day where they cut their hair and get out of Ihram. It is the day that they slaughter their hadi, their animal. It is the day that they make tawaf. It is the day that they make sa'i. So it is a day where there are so many different types of ibadah that come together for the hujjaj and also for the people who are not making hajj. We get up in the morning and we pray Salatul Eid. We continue with our takbirat. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Walillahi alhamd. And we offer our sacrifice on the day of the slaughter, on the day of the sacrifice. So even for people who are not making the pilgrimage, there are so many different forms of ibadah that come together on this day. So when you take all of this together, for the Hujjaj and for the people who are not making Hajj, you see that the 10th of Dhul Hijjah is unlike any other day of the year. And that is what makes it so special. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to see and understand the greatness of this day. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us to do good deeds during this day. The day of Eid is a day where we reflect and we commemorate the great prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ibrahim alayhi salam. Many of the actions that we do on this day, whether it's a person doing Hajj or not, many of the actions can be traced back to the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam and his family. The house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Kaaba, was built by Ibrahim alayhi salam, and his son helped him. His son Ismail alayhi salam assisted his father in the construction of the Kaaba. After he finished the construction of the Kaaba, after Ibrahim alayhi salam finished with this construction, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded him with this verse that we find, وَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ يَأْتُوكَ رِجَالًا وَعَلَىٰ كُلِّ ضَامِرٍ يَأْتِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ فَجٍّ عَمِيقٍ. That call the people to Hajj. Ibrahim alayhi salam has completed the construction of the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he was commanded, now call the people to come and make pilgrimage to this house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They will come on foot and they will come on animals. They will come from every distant place. So Ibrahim alayhi salam, he said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, how can I call them to come? How will they hear my voice if I call out and tell the people, come and make Hajj to the house of Allah in Mecca? How are the people going to hear me? How is this call going to reach the ears of the creation? So it was said to Ibrahim alayhi salam, إِنَّمَا عَلَيْكَ الْأَذَانِ وَعَلَيْنَا الْبَلَاغِ. That it is upon you to make the call, and it is upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make sure that everybody hears it. So Ibrahim alayhi salam in Mecca, some of the scholars said he went onto Mount Safa in Mecca, and some of the scholars said that he went to some other places in Mecca. But the point is that he went and he called the people. He said, Ya ayyuhan nas, inna rabbakum qad ittakhadha baytan fahujjuh. He said, O people, surely your Lord has taken a house. So make pilgrimage to this house. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made that call reach his creation. And everyone who goes to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everyone who makes al-hajj, everyone who makes the pilgrimage, they are answering that call that Ibrahim alayhi salam made under the command of his Lord. For those of us who have made Hajj, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for acceptance. For those of us who have not had the opportunity yet, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you the opportunity to make Hajj. So we commemorate Ibrahim alayhi salam. We reflect upon his sacrifices. We reflect upon how he surrendered to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala completely. We reflect upon the trust that he had in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in all situations. Ibrahim alayhi salam is an example. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قَدْ كَانَتْ لَكُمْ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ فِي إِبْرَاهِيمِ وَالَّذِينَ مَعَهُ. Surely you have a good example in Ibrahim and those who were with him. The only other person that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions something like this about is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. Surely in the Messenger of Allah, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you have a good example. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions this about our messenger, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he also mentions it about Ibrahim alayhi salam. You have a good example in him. Look at this honor that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to Ibrahim alayhi salam. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he commands our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ثُمَّ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ أَنِ اتَّبِعْ مِلَّةَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ حَنِيفًا وَمَا كَانَ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he inspired and he revealed to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to follow the way of Ibrahim alayhi salam, the pure monotheistic way of Ibrahim alayhi salam. And he was not from those who associated partners with Allah. So Ibrahim alayhi salam, look at the honor that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ إِبْرَاهِيمَ خَلِيلًا. And surely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he took Ibrahim. Allah took Ibrahim as a close friend, as a khalil. This is Ibrahim alayhi salam. And the actions that we do on this day are a reflection of the actions of Ibrahim alayhi salam and his family. When you look at the life of Ibrahim alayhi salam, you can say that there are two things about him that stand out. His tawakkul in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his complete trust and dependence upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and his Islam, his submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are two shining attributes of Ibrahim alayhi salam. As for the tawakkul that he had in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, subhanallah, Allah tested him many times. One of the tests that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to Ibrahim alayhi salam, he commanded Ibrahim alayhi salam to take his wife Hajar alayhi salam and their young infant son Ismail alayhi salam. And this was at that time his only son. And he had this son at a very old age. He was in his 80s when he had his son, when Allah blessed him with a son. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded Ibrahim alayhi salam to go to Mecca with Hajar and with Ismail and to leave them in Mecca and to return back to Palestine. And at that time, Mecca was an uninhabited land. There was nothing there. There was no civilization there. There was no source of water there. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded Ibrahim alayhi salam to take them there. Then he commanded him to leave them there. So as he was leaving them there, he's leaving his wife and his infant son, he's walking away. And Hajar alayhi salam, she asks him, "Are you leaving us?" And he doesn't answer. She asks him many times and he doesn't answer. And then she asks, "Allahu amaraka bihadha?" Did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command you to do this? To leave us here? And he says, "Na'am, yes." And then she says, "Idhan la yudayyi'una." Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never cause anything bad to happen to us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will always protect us. Look at the trust that this family had in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibrahim alayhi salam, trusting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah commanded me to leave my family here. I'm going to leave them there and I trust that Allah will take care of them. And the wife of Ibrahim alayhi salam, Hajar alayhi salam, look at her trust, her tawakkul in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as well. So what do you think about a son that is born to these two parents? What kind of a son is he going to become having an upbringing like this from this amazing father and this amazing mother? Subhanallah. That was their son Ismail alayhi salam, who grew up with these parents. Subhanallah. Right? So his trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his family's trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, something so beautiful to reflect upon. Also his submission and his complete surrender to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is another beautiful attribute of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about Ibrahim alayhi salam, إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ أَسْلِمْ قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. When the Lord of Ibrahim alayhi salam said to him, "Aslim," surrender and submit yourself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What was the response of Ibrahim alayhi salam? قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. He said, "I submit and surrender to the Lord of the worlds." And he proved that. It wasn't just something he said with his tongue. It is something that he proved with his actions. When Ismail alayhi salam grew up a little bit, when he was able to walk, he was still a child. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed Ibrahim alayhi salam in a dream that he is slaughtering his son, Ismail alayhi salam. And the dreams of prophets are true. So Ibrahim alayhi salam, he goes to his son, and he's still a child. He goes to Ismail alayhi salam, and he tells him about the dream. He says, "Ya bunayya, O my dear son, inni ara fil manam, truly I have seen in my dream, anni adbahuk, that I am slaughtering you. Fanzur maza tara." So see, what do you think? What was the answer of Ismail alayhi salam, the son of Ibrahim alayhi salam, and the son of Hajar alayhi salam? What did this child say? He said, "Qala ya abati fa'al ma tu'mar." Oh my father, my dear father, do what you have been commanded to do. "Satajiduni insha'allahu min as-sabirin." You will find me insha'allah from those who are patient. I will be patient upon the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah wants you to slaughter me, then I allow that. I'm happy for that to happen, and I will be patient on it. Look at this submission of both the father and the son. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, praising both of them, فَلَمَّا أَسْلَمَا وَتَلَّهُ لِلْجَبِينَ. When they both submitted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Ibrahim alayhi salam placed the head of Ismail alayhi salam in the position to slaughter him, Ibrahim alayhi salam was called out. وَنَادَيْنَاهُ أَنْ يَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ. Ibrahim alayhi salam was called out, Ya Ibrahim, قَدْ صَدَّقْتَ الرُّؤْيَا. You have been true to your dream. إِنَّا كَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Surely this is how we reward the doers of good. إِنَّ هَذَا لَهُوَ الْبَلَاءُ الْمُبِينَ. Surely this is a clear test. Allah tested Ibrahim alayhi salam and Ismail alayhi salam with this. وَفَدَيْنَاهُ بِذِبْحٍ عَظِيمٍ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ransomed Ismail alayhi salam with a great animal to be slaughtered. A ram came down from the sky, and that was slaughtered instead of Ismail alayhi salam. This was the level of submission that Ibrahim alayhi salam and his family had to their creator, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. So this is something that we need to reflect upon as well. These are the lessons that we learn. Have complete trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah will never forsake you. Submit yourself completely to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put blessings in your path, and He will take care of you. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from the people who reflect upon these lessons and implement these lessons practically in our lives. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst the mutawakkileen, from those who trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from amongst the true muslimin, those who truly submit themselves fully to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept everything from us and from you. Ameen. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بهدي سيد المرسلين أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله العظيم الجليل لي ولكم ولجميع المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله على إحسانه والشكر له على توفيقه وامتنانه وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له تعظيما لشأنه وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله الداعي إلى رضوانه. أما بعد. My dear brothers and sisters, there is no action that is more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on this day than النحر, slaughtering an animal. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ما عمل ابن آدم من عمل يوم النحر أحب إلى الله من إهراق الدم. That the son of Adam, the human being, does nothing more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of the slaughter, on the day of the sacrifice, than spilling the blood of an animal, sacrificing an animal. So this is a great sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After Salatul Eid, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would sacrifice an animal out of submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he would ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reward him and his family for this act. So this is a beautiful sunnah that we should make sure that if we have the ability to practice, that we practice it. Offering the udhiyah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَانْحَرْ. So pray to your Lord and sacrifice. So sacrificing an animal on this day is something that is highly, highly encouraged and recommended. If a person cannot do it today, then alhamdulillah, he has the next 3 days to take care of it. It can be done on the Ayyam al-Tashriq as well, on the 11th, the 12th, or the 13th of Dhul Hijjah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made the scope wide for this. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept it from us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have mercy upon us and to forgive and pardon our shortcomings and our faults. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who are successful and from those who are prosperous and from those who gain the true blessing of this amazing day, the day of Eid al-Adha. Ameen. هذا وصلوا وسلموا رحمكم الله على الرسول المجتبى والنبي المصطفى كما أمركم بذلك ربكم جل وعلا. فقال عز من قائل إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا وحبيبنا وقدوتنا محمد بن عبد الله، وارض اللهم عن خلفائه الراشدين أبي بكر الصديق وعمر الفاروق وعثمان ذي النورين وعلي أبي السبطين، وعن العمين الكريمين والسبطين العلمين، وعن الستة الباقين من العشرة المفضلين، وعن أهل بدر والعقبة، وعن سائر الصحابة أجمعين، وعن التابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم فرج هم المهمومين، ونفس كرب المكروبين، واقض الدين عن المدينين، واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين، وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد.
Ankara. Assalamu alaikum.